con noi, innanzitutto perché è un grandissimo regista e quindi ci fa piacere tantissimo averlo, ma anche oltre per questo incontro che fa parte un po' della nostra tradizione, come sa chi ha già partecipato alle altre edizioni del Festival di Roma oppure che conosce le nostre iniziative che svolgiamo nel corso dell'anno, soprattutto per il viaggio del cinema americano, ma anche per un altro motivo che forse per certi versi è anche meno convenzionale e più importante di questi. Infatti Cronenberg, che è un autore di cinema ma anche, come sapete, un regista di opera, di recente ha trasformato in un melodramma uno dei suoi film più belli, più toccanti, La Mosca, che sta peraltro tra poco per esordire come romanziere, oggi durante la conferenza stampa ha fatto questa piccola rivelazione, ma è anche un artista a 360 gradi al punto appunto di prendere 60 dei suoi di alcuni dei suoi fotogrammi delle sue opere più note per trasformarli in vere e proprie opere autonome, immagini che hanno una qualità di invenzione artistica, di inquietudine, di espressività. Ecco, se l'arte significa tenere deste le percezioni, come ha scritto un famoso critico cinematografico, vi invito assolutamente a vedere questa mostra che sta al Palazzo delle Esposizioni ed è curata da Domenico De Gaetano, che è un po' anche il produttore e ideatore di questa iniziativa, perché è forse la prima mostra di cinema in cui il cinema si rivela soprattutto come qualcosa che è fatto di invenzione, inquietudine, estasi, emozione visiva.
Seth, I'm here.
Stop.
Seth.
You were right. I'm diseased and it might be contagious somehow. Every day there, it changes. Every time I look in the mirror, it's someone different, someone hideous, repulsive.
What happened?
I know an old lady who swallowed a fly, perhaps she'll die.
Secondo lei è più efficace, in altre parole, fa più paura nascondere o mostrare nel genere horror?
Well, it's been a kind of a cliche that spoken by people who really don't like to see disturbing things on screen, physical things. They always like to point to Hitchcock, and they said that, you know, Hitchcock was a master of not showing you things and making you afraid. But then I point out that his film Frenzy is in fact very violent and very sexually violent. There's a scene of a rape where the man is strangling the woman with his necktie, and you see the whole thing. And the reason that Hitchcock didn't show things was because he wasn't allowed to. There was a prohibition against showing certain things in films in America at the time. But he, once he had the chance to show those things, he had the desire to show them, because it's showing difficult, horrific, unspeakable things. It means that it must be in your consciousness, it means that you must address it, you must confront the reality that human beings can do these things. And so it really, on the other hand, it completely depends on the kind of film that you're doing. I mean, when I did The Dead Zone, that was a film in which there were some violent moments, but it was a different kind of film. You know, in a way, the movie tells you what it needs. You know, it takes on its own organic life, and it tells you what it needs. And you don't impose on it things that don't work with it. But that's just the relationship between the artist and what he's creating. After I did The Dead Zone, people said, now Cronenberg is being more subtle, he's being more like Hitchcock. But then I did The Fly right after that, you know, because it's a different kind of movie. I mean, this movie is saying, there's something about the human body and disease. At the time that this movie was made, people wanted to connect it with the AIDS epidemic. And I said, well, in fact, there's a disease that is even more universal than AIDS, and that is aging, you know, it's mortality. And for me, the movie is really partly has its power because it is something in a way that we all have to confront, which is the, if we live long enough, we confront the disintegration of our own bodies. And for it's a very difficult thing for a human being to accept his own mortality, his own extinction. And I feel that part of what I do in my films is to try to come to terms with my own mortality, really.
I'm scared. Help me. Please. Please help me.